Hello and welcome back to Medlaunt's M700 tutorial videos. In this video, we will explore how to edit and build new test templates. There are two ways you can edit templates. I'll start by editing directly from the test window, but you can also access your templates directly from the Configure tab. Start by pressing the Perimetry Exam button and choosing the perimeter you plan to use. Once the test window opens, select the test template you want to work from. Medmont doesn't offer the ability to create blank templates, so select a pre-existing template that is most similar to what you intend to create. I'm going to make a sparse adaptive threshold test, so I'll start with a 22A test template. Now, navigate to the Edit tab. Select Edit Template, and a template editing window will open up. You can see that the name at the top of the window, as well as in the name bar, is named after the template that you've based the test on. Once we save our new template, this name will change. Before you start editing the stimulus locations, make sure you understand the mirrored field checkbox. Test templates are saved as eye-specific. With the mirrored field box checked, any changes made in one eye will be mirrored in the other eye. So, for example, if I add 3 points in the periphery of my exam for the left eye, when I select right eye, you will see the points are mirrored across. When I uncheck the box, any changes I make will not transfer between eyes. Please be aware that if you make changes with the mirrored field unchecked, and then you check the box afterwards, the changes you made will be mirrored across both eyes, as you can see here. Any changes unique to a single eye should be made at the end of your customization. As you've likely noticed, to add a point, you simply press on a gray stimulus location. You can either click on points individually, or hold down the mouse as you move over the stimulus locations. Pressing on points that are blue will remove them. If you want to start with a blank template, all you need to do is press the clear button in the bottom left corner. Now that we've covered the basics, let's move to the stimulus parameters in the top right corner. Exposure time is the length of time the stimulus is actually illuminated for. Response determines how long the patient has to respond after the stimulus is exposed. If the patient sees the stimulus and responds, the software will wait for the length of time selected in the delay box before exposing the next stimulus point. If they don't see the point, the next point is exposed as soon as the response time has fully elapsed. You have quite a bit of control over this section. Standard and slow options correspond to the fast and slow buttons in the main test window. As you can see, when I select slow, this option simply gives the patient a little more time to decide on the response by increasing the response and delay times. In keeping with the idea that you really can customize anything you want with your M700 parameter, the clinician selected button lets you control all three of these parameters. The adaptive response option adds a bit of flexibility to the parameters set above. It modifies the response and delay parameters to better suit the patient, speeding up for fast patients to reduce test time, but slowing down if the patient has a hard time responding in time. Moving down the list, we're finally at the test strategy selection stage. Pressing on the drop-down menu shows the list of available test strategies. You thought you were going to finally learn what all the strategies mean, but you're going to have to wait a little longer. However, you will notice the level and the minimum step boxes are faded out. The level box applies only to the fixed level strategy, and is the initial exposure brightness in decibels that is set and that I will refer to when discussing the strategy in the future. The minimum step box is only available for the thresholding strategy, which uses the classic staircasing method many of you will be familiar with. Continuing down, we now have a number of settings that can be turned on or off. Many of the fast screening test strategies have false negatives turned off as a default. Studio tests false negatives by exposing points which have already been seen at a brighter level. If a patient doesn't respond to a point in a location where their threshold is already known, this is marked as a false negative. Many of our fast screening tests have false negatives turned off as a default, since false negatives often occur during longer tests when patients stop paying attention. It is up to you to make the decision as to how important this indicator is for the template you are designing. At low numbers, in shorter tests, they have little statistical significance and may just make the test unnecessarily longer. The most common measure of reliability is false positives, which can be an important indicator early in a test. Because patients can get into a rhythm of responding, the software occasionally skips a point and exposes nothing for one exposure length of time. If a patient indicates that they have seen a point when it was never exposed, a false positive is recorded. This can be a powerful tool for technicians to immediately reevaluate and explain to the patient the importance of only pressing the patient indicator when they are confident they have seen a point. The fluctuation measurement option is another indicator of test reliability. When the test has progressed to an appropriate stage, 4 fully thresholded points that have large defects are chosen. These points are retested 4 times each. At the end of the test, the average of the 4 threshold levels are calculated, and a standard deviation is determined to give a single fluctuation measure for the test. Especially in patients with low vision, fluctuations can be very large around areas at the borders of an absolute defect. A special feature included with the M700 is the ability to design any test with flickering stimulus. Selecting this option enables a test in which the patient is required to respond to the stimulus only if they perceive the target to be flickering. Please read the section on flicker perimetry in the M700 user manual, or watch the additional template tutorial to learn more about how this works. Moving on, you'll see the Test Inside Not Seen Regions option. It works by thresholding around large defects without testing inside of them. When the software finds a continuous, not seen perimeter of a defect, it classifies the entire area as a not seen region. With this button unticked, not seen regions will automatically have all their internal points set as not seen. This is helpful in reducing the test time for patients that are known to have large defects, and is turned off by default during the neurological test. At the very bottom, you can see the Retest Abnormals box. As the visual field test progresses, if the software notices a neighborhood of points which has a single depressed location, it marks it as an abnormal. That point is then retested to ensure that the abnormal value is an actual localized defect, rather than an artifact of patient error. Finally, let's go back to the box I skipped. The spatially adaptive feature is my personal favorite, and allows you to build very powerful thresholding tests. With spatially adaptive turned on, when a point completes, it is checked against the age normal values for that patient at that location. If the threshold is depressed by greater than 6 decibels, all of the surrounding points that have not been selected in the test template are added to the test. This is repeated for every point, quickly expanding around areas of localized defects. In this way, you can build a very sparse field for quick screening, but be confident that any defects will be sufficiently examined. I'll demonstrate the creation of a template now. First, I'm going to clear out all the existing points by pressing clear. Let's build a macular test. I'm going to select 8 points in the central 10 degrees. This may be a little more sparse than you want to use in practice, but it will suffice for the demonstration. The feature I want to demonstrate is spatially adaptive, so I'll make sure that is ticked. Since this is a macular test, we don't want the field extending out past 10 degrees, so I'm going to set the outer boundary to 10 and press OK. Before we start the test, let's save this template we've created. Press Save As in the top left corner and give your test a new name. If you go back to the home page, you'll see your new test displayed in the drop-down menu. If I press Start, you'll notice that despite finding defects, nothing expands. The first thing MedMont Studio does is fully threshold 4 points, to use that data in setting the remaining starting exposures. As we approach completion of 4 points, notice the no in the top point, as well as a fairly low threshold in the central points. Now that the 4 points are complete, you can see that all of the surrounding points have been added in areas of reduced vision. As the test progresses, you'll notice it continuing to expand around areas of low vision until it hits 10 degrees. The simulator has based results on a patient with an arcuate defect, but in a normal patient, this test would have completed in much less than a minute with no points expanding outwards. To finish this demo off, I'd like to close down the test simulator. We're going to go to the Configure tab, and you'll see there is a template setup option in the M700 panel. Press on this, and you'll see all of the templates you have available. Whereas the test window is the best place to build new templates from, if you need to delete or modify your pre-existing templates, this is where you need to be. You can see that the test we just built is at the bottom of the list. It is the only user-defined template, and as such, the only one we can edit. MedWant Studio doesn't allow you to edit the built-in templates to keep the standards consistent. Finally, from this window, you can import new templates and export your old templates to share between practices. To find out more, take a look at the user manual. That's it for now. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time for a discussion on test templates.